chemistry. We are going to study today general organic chemistry. See, general organic chemistry, there is nothing a chapter called GOC in NCRT. NCRT में देखोगे GOC कहीं मिलेगा ही नहीं general. थोड़ा बहुत hydro carbon chapter में कहीं नहीं दिया हुआ है. Specific chapter GOC है. GOC actually here will discuss all kind of effects of organic chemistry. It actually builds your base of organic chemistry. Okay? Reaction कैसे होगा, stability factor कैसे हमें identify करना है, सारा कुछ will study over here. Okay? So this is very important, okay? GOC and reaction mechanism, two different chapters we have, which is not given in NCERT. That's why it's very difficult to go through organic chemistry chapter. Because basic चीज पढ़ते नहीं हैं. जैसे if you see the in competitive like in this coaching institutes, they'll teach GOC more than a month. सिर्फ GOC पढ़ाते हैं. Reaction mechanism 2 महीने पढ़ाएंगे वो, 2.5 महीने पढ़ाएंगे, 2.5 months ऐसे पढ़ाएंगे reaction mechanism. ठीक है, and once you finish this, organic chemistry is almost done 80%. Because reaction mechanism में we discuss most of the reactions. Means path of the reaction we'll discuss. कि क्या product major बन सकता है, क्या mechanism होगा, what is the dominating product we have. Okay, so all these things we'll discuss in reaction mechanism, which you know unfortunately in school they don't teach. Because curriculum ऐसा नहीं आता नहीं उनको, curriculum उनका वैसा है, वो उतना जाते नहीं है depth. But for competitive exam you should understand those things. Okay, मैंने भी पढ़ा है राजीनगर में, बिल्कुल अलग pattern. वो ये भी है advanced batch over there, batch one राजीनगर. So I taught them this way only. GOC पढ़ाया, reaction mechanism पढ़ाया, and उनका school अलग चल रहा है, अलग चला. They were comfortable with it. Okay, so if you are comfortable, I will go according to that only. Okay, so so once you do not know reaction mechanism, once you do not know organic this GOC, it is very difficult to understand organic chemistry. क्योंकि एक लॉजिक से कहीं कुछ और हो रहा होगा और दूसरे लॉजिक से कहीं कुछ और हो जाएगा. सेम कंडीशन. सो व्हाट इज द डोमिनेटिंग फैक्टर, उसके अकॉर्डिंग हम लोग वो पता होना चाहिए कि डोमिनेटिंग फैक्टर क्या है. जैसे कार्बोकैटायन, यू नो व्हाट इज कार्बोकैटायन, कार्बोकैटायन इज एन इंटरमीडिएट. ठीक है, कोई भी रिएक्शन जैसे हो रहा है वहां पे विल हैव डिफरेंट डिफरेंट इंटरमीडिएट फॉर्म्स इन अ रिएक्शन. कार्बोकैटायन, कार्बन आयन, फ्री रेडिकल, नाइट्रीन्स, कार्बीन्स, बेंजाइन्स, all these are free radicals, sorry intermediates here. So there is a chapter called organic compound containing nitrogen, amines. There is a chapter in organic chemistry. वहाँ पे most of the reaction, even in carbonyl compound, there are many reactions which proceeds by the formation with the formation of an intermediate called nitrines. Okay. So what is nitrine intermediate? वो पता होना चाहिए. Under what circumstances this intermediate can form? वो पता होना चाहिए. Then you can correlate. अदरवाइज तो रिएक्शन है वो भी याद करना पड़ेगा कि ये रिएक्शन ऐसे ये प्रोडक्ट दे रहा है, राइट? सो ऑल दोस थिंग्स विल अस अंडरस्टैंड हियर, ओके? सो जीओसी एक्चुअली इट एक्सप्लेन्स द स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ वेरियस इंटरमीडिएट्स, ओके? व्हाट आर द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक इफेक्ट्स, इलेक्ट्रॉनिक इफेक्ट जो कि मॉलिक्यूल में प्रेजेंट होते हैं. इलेक्ट्रॉनिक मीन्स हाउ द इलेक्ट्रॉन डिस्प्लेस विद इन अ मॉलिक्यूल. समझे ये बात? इलेक्ट्रॉनिक इफेक्ट मीन बाय व्हाट इफेक्ट द इलेक्ट्रॉन डिस्प्लेस. जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल मैं एक एग्जांपल लिखता हूं यहां पे. व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ दिस कंपाउंड, CH2 डबल बॉन्ड, CH सिंगल बॉन्ड, CH डबल बॉन्ड, CH2. आईयूपीएसी नेम,
दिस इज
1.3 ब्यूटाडाइन.
यस
है ना, 1.3 ब्यूटाडाइन. सो व्हेन दिस रिएक्शन टेक्स प्लेस विद HBr, HBr के साथ इसका एडिशन रिएक्शन होगा. Means H plus Br minus जाके इस पे अटैच होगा. अब ये जब रिएक्शन होगा, actually you see this double bond means there is density of electron. Double bond मतलब क्या है? Lateral overlap है ऐसे. So we have weak electron cloud present between the carbon atom. So this weak electron cloud attracts nucleophile. Okay? Sorry, attracts electrophile. Electrophile and nucleophile two reagents we have. Reagents are those compounds which attacks. ओके, सो रिएक्शन कैसे होता है? एक किसी पे अटैक करता है, जो अटैक कर रहा है वो रिएजेंट है, जिस पे अटैक हो रहा है दैट इज सबस्ट्रेट. अंडरस्टूड? सबस्ट्रेट एंड रिएजेंट, सबस्ट्रेट्स आर व्हाट, सबस्ट्रेट्स आर द कंपाउंड्स व्हिच आर गेटिंग अटैक्ड बाय द अदर कंपाउंड्स. रिएजेंट्स आर दोस कंपाउंड्स व्हिच अटैक्स ऑन सबस्ट्रेट. ओके, सो रिएजेंट्स कैन बी न्यूक्लियोफाइल, एंड यू माइनस इज द सिंबल ऑफ न्यूक्लियोफाइल, जनरल सिंबल ऑफ न्यूक्लियोफाइल. Electrophile is E plus. okay. NU minus is nucleophile. Nucleophile means nucleus lovers. Okay, nucleus kya hota hai? Positively charged, right? Nucleus is positively charged. So nucleus lover is what? Must be negatively charged. That's why you see NU minus will write. Nucleophile means nucleus lover. Nucleus is positively charged, so nucleophile must be negatively charged or electron rich species. Jahan pe lone pair present. Okay. Electrophiles are what? Electrophiles are electron lovers. Okay. Electrophiles, electron lovers. So electrons are negatively charged. So electrophiles must be positively charged or electron deficient species. Jo ki electron ko attack kar sakte. So ye jo electron cloud hai yahan pe, this pi bond, which is weakly bonded to carbon atom. If any electrophile is there, this electrophile has tendency to get attracted by this, to get attracted towards this electron cloud, pi electron cloud. ठीक है? So ये जब electrophile इस पे attack करेगा, so this pi electron has the tendency to shift either onto this carbon or onto this carbon. ठीक है? Now suppose अब ये nucleophile suppose I am taking. So when this nucleophile is trying to attack, this pi bond will shift onto this carbon and forms a carbocation here, positive charge. Why positive charge? Because dekho yahan pe kya hai? This bond pair of electron is shared between the two carbon atom. When this two electron is taken by this carbon atom, it means this carbon has this one electron has been used by this carbon atom and it goes onto this carbon. So this carbon will have one positive charge. This positive charge, now this nucleophile attacks onto this positive charge. Okay, so इस केस में जो expected product है यहाँ पे, that is CH2 double bond CH single bond CH single bond CH Br and CH3, क्योंकि ये negative charge will take this H plus and this positive charge will take this Br minus. This was the expected product in this reaction. But the actual product that you get here, or the major product that you get here, is this H3C CH double bond CH single bond CH2 Br. Means यहाँ पे क्या हुआ? First and fourth carbon पे addition हो रहा है. And this is the major product, not this one. Okay, just you listen to me. Okay. 1,4 addition gives you this. We were expecting 1,2 addition. First and second carbon pair addition we were expecting, but this is the actual result we are getting. Okay, this happens because of an electronic effect, and that effect we call it as resonance. Okay, actually with this example only we got this concept of resonance. Okay, so through resonance what happens? The electron pair shift and we'll get positive charge at one of the carbon atom, terminal carbon atom, and negative charge on other carbon atom, and then there H plus and Br minus. Okay, so point is how this product we are getting. For that you should understand the electronic effects, how the electron is getting shifted into the molecule. Okay, so uske liye hum log kya padhenge? Various electronic effects padhenge. Okay, so there are three main electronic effects we have. Inductive effect you must have heard, inductive effect, resonance, mesoric effect, and hyperconjugation. Okay, so write down the various electronic effect. Heading you write down the various electronic effects. The first one you write down, inductive effect. Mesomeric effect. In this only, we'll discuss about resonance. Resonance briefly we have discussed in chemical bonding, what is resonance. Okay, here we'll discuss in detail. Okay, the third one is hyperconjugation. Hyperconjugation, and the fourth one is electromeric effect. Electromeric effect least important, just you write it. Electromeric effect. Okay. One kind of question that they ask out of this four electronic effects, the first three are permanent effect. So ye question exam mein aa chuka hai. which one of this is permanent, which one of this is temporary. Okay, electromagnetic is temporary effect.
Electromagnetic is the, is that thing where it induces the
induces, ha. Double bond pe agar attack hua, then agar electrophile ko remove kar lo, so wapas the original compound you will get. Okay, the example that we have taken, no? Electrophile attacks, you remove electrolyte, electrophile, original compound you'll get again. Okay, so this takes place under the influence of a reagent like electrophile or neutrophile. That's why it is temporary effect. All these are permanent. Okay, mesomeric effect ko hum log resonance effect bhi bolte hain. Okay, mesomeric effect ko resonance effect bhi bolte hain. Both are same thing. ठीक है, इंडक्टिव इफेक्ट, वी हैव टू टाइप्स ऑफ इंडक्टिव इफेक्ट, प्लस आई एंड माइनस आई. ठीक है, सो देखेंगे हम लोग सेपरेटली, अलग अलग देखेंगे व्हाट इज प्लस आई माइनस आई. मेसोमेरिक इफेक्ट को वी आल्सो वी हैव टू टाइप, प्लस एम एंड माइनस एम. प्लस एम लिखो, प्लस आर लिखो, बोथ आर सेम थिंग. माइनस एम लिखो, माइनस आर लिखो, बोथ आर सेम थिंग. ओके, हाइपरकॉन्जुगेशन आल्सो वी हैव टू टाइप्स, प्लस एच and minus H. Okay, plus and minus is not charged, it represents electron releasing and electron withdrawing tendency. Okay, plus means what? Electron release karega, molecule ko electron dega. Minus means what? It is withdrawing, electron withdrawing, molecule se electron ko khichega, withdraw karega, right? So first we are going to discuss is inductive effect right now. Two, three characteristics of inductive effect we have that you write down. First point, important. These characteristics are also important. Write down. Inductive effect, it is a, like I said, permanent effect. Inductive effect, permanent effect. It is distance dependent. Write down two, three points, we'll discuss what is the meaning of this. It is distance dependent. As the distance increases, the effect decreases. The effect decreases. Effect decreases. It is the reason of dipole moment in the molecule. It is the reason of dipole moment in the molecule.
So this is just the delta positive, delta
negative. Delta positive, delta negative. Okay. You see, for this one example, I'll write down here. CH3, one more point. Right now, the effect of this is considered to be negligible after second or third carbon. In some book they write third, in some book they write second. Generally, we'll take second, after second or third carbon. ठीक है? ये example देखो. CH3, CH2. CH2, and Cl. What is the name of this compound?
Chlorobutane.
Butyl chloride. कुछ भी बोल सकते हैं. One chlorobutane, right? So, अब what is the difference in all these? The major difference क्या है? Is carbon, 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 carbon. All are sp3 hybridized. ठीक है? Any doubt? sp3 है. ठीक है, सो इसका इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी ऑफ ऑल दिस कार्बन एटम विल बी सेम. ठीक है, सो व्हेन द इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिविटी इज सेम, सो द बॉन्ड पेयर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन विल बी एग्जैक्टली इन बिटवीन द टू कार्बन एटम. ठीक है, शिफ्टिंग नहीं होगा, राइट? बट दिस क्लोरीन इज व्हाट? इट इज मोर इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव देन दिस कार्बन एटम. सो ये क्लोरीन क्या करेगा? ये बॉन्ड पेयर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन को अपनी ओर अट्रैक्ट करेगा. ठीक है, और क्लोरीन के साइड में इलेक्ट्रॉन डेंसिटी विल इंक्रीज. ठीक है, when electron density increases, so here we have delta negative charge, we get from delta negative charge, and this carbon will get delta positive charge. Of this delta positive charge, this carbon in comparison to this becomes again more electron deficient comparatively. If you see, this will also attract this bond pair of electron, so here also the charge decreases, delta delta positive. It does not mean the charge is increasing, means as you are going away from this atom, the positive charge is decreasing, and that is why the effect is decreasing. Inductive effect is decreasing. What I said, these are electronic effects. right? Electronic effects means what? Tendency to attract electron, shift electron within the molecule, right? So ye dekho yahan pe, because of electronegativity difference, the electron or what? The bond pair of electron is shifting from one point to other. The shift is not, it is a partial shift. Completely shifting, complete shifting is not there. Understood? The, you see, when this electron pair shifted, how this bond forms? We have a p orbital of carbon and the p orbital of chlorine overlaps. Here, okay? And here two electrons. Okay? So shifting of electron means that this electron pair does not come out of this orbital and shift onto this chlorine. It is just slightly shifted towards the chlorine atom. Okay? So the bond pair of electron will be there in the orbital, but towards the chlorine atom. Center pe nahi hoga. Got it? This is partial shift. Okay, this is partial shift. That's why you have partial charge. Isko nikal ke yahan pe dal do completely, then we'll write negative charge, not positive charge. Okay? Or not delta negative. We'll write full charge, complete charge, that is negative charge. So this what happens here. The reason of this kind of shifting is what? Electronegativity difference. Okay? So reason is electronegativity difference. And why this is permanent? Because when you take butyl chloride, so ye shifting to hogi hoga hi hoga. Aisa to nahi hai ki abhi liya to nahi hoga aur baad mein loge to hoga. Whenever you take this molecule, the shifting will be there because this and this is bonded. Correct? That's why this effect is what? This effect is permanent effect. When you take this molecule, the shifting will be like this. Okay? And what kind of electron is taking part in this? Sigma electron. Shared pair of electron, but sigma, not pi. Pi electron won't take part in inductivity. So write down this point also. It involves only sigma electron. Distance dependent involves only sigma electron. It has nothing to do with pi electron. Pi electron jaisa hai waisa hi rahega. Usme koi change nahi karna hai. Theek hai? Sigma electrons. Okay. Now, inductive effect, like I said, it is two types: plus I and minus I. Minus I is more important. Write down. What is minus I effect? Minus I effect is, it is because of the electron withdrawing nature. It is because of the electron withdrawing nature. It is because of the electron withdrawing nature.
I'll just put this thing down.
Okay, so minus I effect is, it is because of the electron withdrawing nature, like this one. This one is withdrawing electron from this molecule. This shows minus I effect. Okay, so minus I is electron withdrawing, plus I is electron releasing. In general, electron, there are many electron withdrawing groups in comparison to the electron releasing group. Plus I groups are very less in number in comparison to minus I group, right? That's why minus I is more important effect. Okay, for example, suppose logically also you can find out which one is more electron withdrawing nature. Like suppose main agar tumse puchta hu ye hamare paas hai fluorine, bromine and iodine. Which one has more minus I effect?
Fluorine.
Fluorine, obviously, because fluorine is more electronegative, so order is this. Okay? So logically you can find out which one is more electron withdrawing. Okay? Suppose main agar ye likh dun, OH, theek hai? OH group attached hai and SH attached. Which one is more electron withdrawing? OH or SH? Huh?
OH.
NH2 and PH2. What we need to check? The electron withdrawing tendency. And this, see, this means what? This O is attached to the molecule. Like suppose yahan pe maine ye molecule liya, yahan pe OH laga diya. Ye liya, fir SH laga diya. So which one will withdraw more electron?
Oxygen.
Oxygen, because oxygen is more electronegative than sulfur. Means jo difference hai uske basis pe comparison karna hai. Okay? So OH and SH, if you place here, obviously oxygen is more electronegative than sulfur. This will withdraw more electron. The minus I effect of OH is more than with that of.
So oxygen will withdraw an electron from hydrogen and the neighboring hydrogen. Two hydrogens.
No, not hydrogen.
Carbon.
Ye bond pair electron withdraw kare. Carbon or oxygen.
So, no, from the hydrogen that it's bonded to, it will withdraw electron from that hydrogen also.
This also will come this side. That's why this hydrogen is slightly acidic in nature. But we are considering what? We are considering this part.
The carbon.
Molecule kono dekha. Okay? That's why alcohols are slightly acidic in nature. Okay? CH3OH agar do, CH2H5OH do. So oxygen hydrogen ke beech will have electronegative difference. The bond pair of electrons slightly attracted towards the oxygen atom. Hence H plus can go out into the solution easily. That's why alcohols are slightly acidic in nature. Okay? NH2 and PH2 again nitrogen ki electronegativity is more, and hence the order of minus I is this. So logically you can do this. Okay, some more example I'll write down. Examples are very important in this. Suppose main agar ye example likhta hu, N double bond O and NO. Which one is more electronegative? Ab dono hi nitrogen hai. So ek mein to there are two oxygen.
So I think that one is more.
Which one?
NO.
Why NO is more?
So because like over here you have two oxygens which are sucking the.
Okay.
Oh, don't, no,
so
no,
this
no,
hydrogen
yes,
becomes
no.
more electron deficient.
Yes, sir.
This will attract more electrons.
Yes.
And also the electron minus I effect N2 ka jada oxygen jada electron withdraw kare, right?